Hi, I'm Apollo. Let me tell you about what's new in Swift Charts. Swift Charts enables the creation of informative, accessible, and delightful visualizations using Swift UI. This release brings to you new charts to present weather trends, track your mood and vitals, and graph functions in math notes. That's right. Swift Charts now allows you to visualize things beyond data by plotting mathematical functions in your apps. Swift Charts now also has vectorized plotting APIs that support visualizing larger datasets even more efficiently. I've plotted this video to teach you more about each of these exciting new capabilities of Swift Charts, starting with function plots, which introduce two new APIs. Line plot for visualizing a single function, and area plot to fill in the area between two functions. Let me take you through how function plots can help me with data analysis. I've been researching large-scale solar energy projects in the contiguous United States using a dataset from US Geological Survey. I built a histogram to visualize the solar panel's capacity densities with a for each over the data points and a bar mark for each element. You know what? This histogram suggests that capacity density may be normally distributed. I'll compare by plotting a normal distribution using the new function plot API. I've defined a function that calculates the points on a normal distribution curve, and I can plot it using the new line plot API, which accepts a closure that takes the double and returns the double. So I can call my function with a pre-computed mean and standard deviation. It's fundamental to Swift Charts that data visualizations are accessible to everyone. Swift Charts makes your chart accessible by default. I can use VoiceOver to describe the chart.
The x-axis is capacity density. The y-axis is probability. There are two data series.
Audio graph works on a function plot, too.
Complete.
Great! And just like in Swift UI, you can use modifiers to customize how your functions look. Here, because the line plot has the same default color as the bars, it's a good idea to customize the color of my function plot with a different foreground style. Much better now. But to make it stand out just a little more, I would like to fill in the area below the curve. To do that, I can simply change the line plot to an area plot. Then, to increase the contrast, I can further customize the area plot with an opacity to make it more legible. So that's how to plot a simple math function. But Swift Charts makes it just as easy to build more advanced function plots. For example, not only can area plot visualize the area under a curve, we can use it to visualize the area between two functions as well, by returning a tuple of y start and y end for a given input x. Unlike visualizing data, a function can accept an unbounded range of x values. By default, Swift Charts automatically infers the domain by sampling the function. But I can customize the overall bounds of the chart by setting the x scale and the y scale to include only parts of the function that I find interesting. I also have the ability to limit the domain of the function plot itself. By restricting area plot sampling domain, the chart now includes only the middle part of this function. Swift Charts also supports plotting parametric functions. Here's a parametric function, where x and y are defined in terms of a third variable, t. Let's plot it. You can graph parametric functions in Swift Charts by using the same lineplot API, but return both x and y values given the value t. I love it. Next, let's talk about how to handle piecewise functions. Sometimes a piecewise function doesn't have an output for certain values in its domain. In those cases, you can return .nan to inform Swift Charts that there's not a number for that input value x. In other cases, your code might trap for certain x values, such as when evaluating 1 over x when x is equal to 0. Similarly, you should handle the special values by returning .nan. That's function plotting with line plot and area plot, where they treat an entire math function as a single entity. But the plot APIs are useful for more than just functions. They can make it more convenient and more efficient to visualize larger datasets. So, we've added plot API variants for all other mark types, too. These vectorized plot APIs can handle an entire collection in parallel to draw extensive data visualizations, such as a scatter plot for a classification model, or a heat map visualizing self-attention in a transformer language model. But before I let the plot thicken, let's review how you would declare a chart using the Mark API. Marks are super flexible, allowing you to style each individual data point differently, from choosing which modifiers to apply, to even what kind of mark to use. However, most often, you don't need this level of customization. It's common for an entire collection of data points to be styled homogeneously, using the same element properties for X, Y, foreground style, and other visual attributes. In contrast, the new vectorized plot API, such as rectangle plot, allows Swift Charts to process larger collections of data more efficiently. For an example of vectorized plots, let's go back to our solar panel dataset. I want to add a visualization of all the solar panel installations to my app. For all the points in this chart, I'd like to customize them in the same way. The size will be determined by the capacity, and they will be colored differently based on the panel's axis type. The dataset has raw GPS coordinates in longitude and latitude, but I want to apply outburst projection to display the points on a flat surface. I could add computed properties in extension to do this conversion on the fly, but to get the most out of vectorized plots, I'll add them as stored properties instead. Store properties allow Swift Charts to access the x and y values for all data points with a constant memory offset instead of calling the getter for every data point. The new point plot API takes an entire collection of data to plot. For the x and y values of all the points in the plot, I can use the same .value syntax with a label and a key path to the stored properties x and y of the data point structure. If you've used SwiftUI before, you might have already used KeyPath. Using KeyPath lets Swift charts style all the points without iterating over the dataset. Modifiers for vectorized plots take KeyPath as well. With simple size, I make the size of each point represent its solar panel capacity, and similarly, I use a KeyPath to the solar panel's axis type to customize the color of each point. All other modifiers that are often used for homogeneous modification support a KeyPath parameter too. My app looks stunning in Apple Vision Pro with spatial computing. The vectorized plot on my left animates smoothly, and all the charts on my dashboard update simultaneously while I scrub through the bar chart. With pinch and drag, I can get a closer look at the vectorized plot we just added to learn more about each solar panel installation and glance over the normal distribution plot that we created earlier. That's vectorized plots. Now you might be wondering how vectorized plots and marks complement each other. Use vectorized plots for larger datasets, where the entire plot is customized with the same modifiers and properties. Use the mark API when you have fewer data points, but need to customize each element with individual mark types and modifiers. Or if you need complex layering with Z index. When using vectorized plots, you can help Swift charts reduce the number of style alternations by grouping the collection of data by the style you will use for them. Avoiding other computations during rendering can help too, such as by converting computed properties to stored properties. If you already know the few distinct styles you use or the overall bounds of the chart, specifying them will render your charts more efficiently. And lastly, it's common for some style customizations to be unnoticeable with larger amount of data points, so you can skip those entirely to make your chart even more performant. That's the new vectorized and function plots in Swift Charts. Try out these new features to take your visualizations to the next level, and download the sample project to check out more examples of function plots, including how you can add interactions to them. If you are new to Swift Charts, check out previous talks to get started. Thank you, and I look forward to what you'll plot next.